Hey folks, we're down here at City Hall in Toronto. We're gonna talk about street photography today. We're going to start here at City Hall and we're gonna work our way down to Queen Street West and to Chinatown. So basically we're gonna talk about three types of street photography. The first type will be candid, and that's where we're kind of in stealth mode, where we're trying to get stories with our photos. You know, people talking, people interacting, and we kind of have to be in stealth mode so that we don't ruin that story. Second of all, we're going to try to do some interactive street photography where we're going to talk to people, we're going to ask for the permission to get the picture, maybe even get a story so that we can take their photo better. And lastly, we're going to do some urban photography. This is more about architecture of the city, something that's specific to the area that you're in, something that will mean something, that'll tell you that, hey, we're in Toronto, we're at City Hall here. So, let's go. I've got a couple of options here. I've got my 24 to 120 4.0 Nikon lens, which is a great walk-around lens. It allows me to do my urban photography because I can get the whole building in. It allows me to do some nice portrait work because I can get up and close. But I also brought in my 70 to 200 lens, which gives me the great 2.8 all the way down. It allows me to do my stealth mode shots, you know, where I'm trying to get my stories. So I think for where we are, we're going to start with the 24 to 120. And we're just going to do a whole mix of things right now because there's not a lot going on here. There's not a lot of interesting, unique people. So let's see what we get, okay? So when we're asking people if we can take their photo, you have to be very respectful of their feelings. It's okay if they say no, and this lady behind me, I went up to her and asked her if we could take her picture and film it, and right away she was not comfortable with it, so I have to respect that, and that's okay. So we're just gonna look around and see if we can find somebody that'll let us take their picture. So you have to be prepared to get shut out a lot. You can't take it personally. For whatever reason, they didn't want their picture taken. I have to respect that. And you know, we'll just go on to the next person. Probably I'll hit about 50% of the people that will let me take their picture versus the people that won't let me take their picture. And it really depends where you are. Some cities are a little harder than others. I find in New York, almost everybody will let you take their picture. They just seem to be a little more friendly there. Here we're very polite, but we seem to be a little more guarded. So we just expect that and away we go. Hi, I'm taking some street photography for my photo club. More of a learning tool, and I'm wondering if I can take your photo and film it to see and use it as a training video.
Sure.
Is that okay?
Sure.
Okay, I'm Randy, by the way.
Mark.
Mark, nice to meet you, Mark. Mark, you know what, let's get something that, and if you give me your email address, I'll send it to you, okay? So why don't we just use the bench here, if that's
sure.
Okay. And you know what, let's go around to the other side and see what it's like this way with the background.
Right.
Yeah.
Shall I sit down?
Yep, sit down to get comfortable. So I'm gonna use some film flash here, okay? And don't be shy. Tell me something about yourself, actually.
I'm actually here to film.
Are you? So we're kind of down that. And you'll see that I'm not very good at the video part of this, but I'm okay with the photo part.
Then the opposite. I'm doing the video, but not the photo part.
Well, I really appreciate you letting me do this. Okay, so let's get you just turning a little sideways and just look at me. That's perfect. Nice and long.
Yeah, that's good.
You all set?
Mm-hmm.
Awesome. Oh, this is perfect. Let's have a little look.
Yeah,
I think
good.
This is actually quite good. Quite happy with that.
Yeah, it works. Everything's lit. Yeah.
Excellent.
Nice.
Well, listen, thanks very much. I appreciate
your
time.
No problem.
You have a great day, okay?
Yeah, good luck.
Bye now. Sure. So we're gonna try an urban type of shot now. We're gonna try to get some bike motion to make it more interesting to get the Simcoe house that's in the background over there. So I'm probably gonna have to go down to like 1/20th of a second and maybe even 1/10th of a second to get the motion of the bike through. I'm gonna probably have to take a few test shots. So we're gonna see how that goes, okay? One of the things you have to keep in mind is that when you're shooting at such a slow speed, you really have to push your aperture up so that you can let less light in, or else you're just gonna blow out all your photos. So that's one of the things I just noticed with that shot I just took, is that I blew out the background. Now I have to wait for another bike driver to come by. See, you have to not get frustrated. I'm getting blockages all the time. I got streetcars stopping here. I'm missing motorcycles going by. You just have to be patient, wait it out, and just enjoy yourself. Enjoy the sights that you're seeing. So you might wonder where I'm focusing to get the shot. And because I want the bike rider to be out of focus, I'm focusing actually on the backdrop, and then when they come through, I'm trying to catch them. That way the camera doesn't have to catch up to the bike riders and focus on them and get them blurry through. That tends to work. Sometimes I try to pan with them as well, because you may want to try that as well. Right now it looks like we're kind of out of bike riders, so we're going to go down the street. If we see some more, we might try it, but right now I'm on manual mode, a 20th of a second f/14 because of the light, and that seems to be working. You're going to see an example of at least the motion.
Can
I take one more?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Beautiful.
Ready?
Yeah.
Beautiful. Oh, even better.
Oh, nice smile.
Beautiful. Very nice.
What's your name?
Alan.
Alan?
Alan.
Alan. I'm Randy. Nice to meet you. So we're starting to head down Queen Street West now. You can see that the colors are starting to come out, the texture of this street, which is like one of the best streets for street photography. The people are very interesting. I think I'm going to stick with my 24 to 120 because I'm going to try to actually ask people for their photos now, so more of the interactive stuff.
Great.
I'm Randy, by the way.
Colin?
Kidra. Kidra, very, very nice to meet you too. And if you don't like the picture, by the way, we'll toss it, okay? Yeah. All right, everybody look at me. That's it. One more nice and close up here. Beautiful, guys. Beautiful.
Out of Vancouver, she's always in there looking for us.
Oh, look at this. This is awesome. As I like to say, awesome in its awesomeness.
Yeah, no, that's good. That's
a good one.
Yeah, you should send that to us.
I will. Actually, do you have it?
Yep.
Hey, John, you want to grab? I get really picky, right?
Yeah. Me too.
Someone like you is, I don't run into someone like you all the time, right? You mind if you take a couple more? Okay, but I like that, yes. I'm doing some street photography.
What's that?
I'm doing some street photography, and we're using it to teach the members of our club kind of how to do it respectfully. Mm-hmm. And you're a pretty cool looking dude. Can I take a picture of you? And if you don't like it, I'll get rid of it.
If you want.
I'd love that. Thanks a lot, eh? I appreciate
that.
How
you want me to...
Right there, just the way you are is perfect. In fact, you know what? If we go down a little bit, there's a storefront that actually doesn't have this bright light on us.
Okay, so
it's right here. My name's Randy, by the way.
Alan.
Alan, nice to meet you, man. And if I can just get you to move away from this little thingy there. Okay, perfect. I'm gonna get one more, okay, pal? Very nice. Very, very nice. How about you? Beautiful.
Cool.
Do you have an email address?
Yes, I do.
Okay, I will send it to you, actually.
Amazing.
Do you have a card? I'm good with that. Here we go. Yeah, beautiful. Just gorgeous. Thank you so much. Okay,
thank
appreciate
you.
It. Have a great day.
You too, guys.
Goodbye. Okay, remember, shooting through glass, just don't be afraid of it. So he obviously didn't want to get his picture taken, but that's okay. We have a comical photo there. So graffiti is very, it catches your eye really quickly, and a lot of people love to just shoot the graffiti, but it is somebody else's art, and all by itself, it's just color. And I think you have to do something else. You have to have people in it. You have to use it as more of a backdrop than the main focus of the photo. So right now, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna try to do some urban photography and try to get this metalwork incorporated with the graffiti so at least has a center of interest. And I think you'll find that, you know, when you're taking pictures of graffiti, you have to find something to make it stand out other than just the artwork itself, okay? We'll have to see how this all comes out, but again, you'll find that if you're just shooting graffiti all by itself, it's not enough. You need something else. You need something like, even this grate helps us separate the door and the graffiti from just itself. So at least the grate gives us some structure. Yeah, so I think that might work, so we'll see. So now we're in the heart of Chinatown. We're hopefully gonna get some great interactions between the shopkeepers and the people buying their goods and services. Let's see what we can get down here.
Okay.
Okay. I like it. Stay right there. And okay, let's look. Beautiful.
Okay.
Yeah, look at
very nice.
Thank you. Top it. Good. Ah, we lost him, eh? You have to go to manual focus when you're shooting through glass because it wants to focus on the glass itself. And quite often you lose your opportunity like I just did there. He took off.
Oh yeah.
Okay. Oh, thank you very much. Important to give back. I mean, we're down here, we're taking pictures of whatever we want. Most people are being really nice to us. She's hungry. What's $5 for a Tim Hortons card? So I think it's really important that you do that, and I think it'll come back to you in spades.
Try one more baseball on here.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a complete disaster. So it's hit and miss when you're shooting from the hip. Yep. Really off. Dang, got it.
Okay.
So, he takes your chances. I got two good ones and two really nothings. Which way, John? Okay, so by now, we've taken a lot of pose shots and we've taken a lot of candid shots. By far, it's a lot easier for me personally to actually take the pose shot because I get to talk to the people, I get to find out about them. And quite often, I mean occasionally they're not going to want you to take their pictures, but there's so many subjects out here. You should just keep asking. And don't be afraid, like you're allowed to be here. You're allowed to take street photos, it's not against the law. I personally like to be as respectful as I can because there's lots of people to take pictures of. The candid shots are important because you want to get a story. And there's some people that they're just so interesting that, you know, you don't want to lose the opportunity for the photo. But remember, you do have it's your right to be out here. And it's really about, if you use your discretion, you're going to respect the people that you take pictures of, it's all going to be just fine. So that's kind of what I think about when it comes to pose pictures versus candid shots. So I just want to talk for a second about copyrights and what your legal right is for taking pictures on the street. Typically in Canada, you're allowed to take pictures in any public venue. It's really about what you do with the photo afterwards. So, you know, model releases and those things may come into effect. You should check your local bylaws and your local laws to make sure that they're the same as what I'm saying to you now. What you have to look out for is government facilities and private property. They have the right to kick you off the property. They do not have the right to take your camera. Okay, so just remember that too. But if you're on a public street and you're taking photos, you're allowed to do that. Okay, so here's something I've never seen before, and I've lived in Toronto my whole life. The backside of City Hall makes this excellent S-like design that I find pretty cool. Like, you may like it or not like it, but it's just something I've never seen before. So you always have to keep your mind open and keep looking for different shapes and everything that you're doing. I mean, and this is a great example. Let's just look at it one more time up there. Like, I've never really noticed that shape in that building before. So again, keep looking, keep shooting.
Toronto, my name is Woody. I rule the world.
Where are you from? Where are you from, Woody?
Cool. That's it, buddy. Just smile right there. That's it. Awesome, awesome. Oh, here, bud. Let's have a look. Look, that's you, okay? This is who you are.
Oh, that's not a bad shot.
That's a great shot. Are you kidding?
I got a big nose, though.
No, you don't. No, you got a good smile, though. Good smile.
Yeah.
A Trinidadian
smile. Well, I brush my teeth every day. Yeah,
that's good. Okay, keep that up, okay? People like that. Hey, get a picture of us here, eh? Do you mind?
No, I gotta go home.
Can I get one quick picture of you and
me? Yeah, you can. Yeah,
here,
sure.
But just point you. No, keep your bike. Keep your bike.
Actually, it's my roommate's bike. Somebody stole my bike. I had
a nice. That's never good. Okay, you ready? Okay, I'm ready when you are, John. Okay, so we've made it back to City Hall where we started from. I think now I'd like to just say the things that I've learned today, because I'm always learning, and I think it's important for you to keep your mind open to learn. I learned today that I mostly used my 24 to 120 lens. I thought that by bringing my 70 to 200 2.8 I'd have better bokeh type of shots, but honestly I ended up carrying a heavy lens for maybe two or three photos. Another thing I learned today was I shot in aperture mode most of the time. Like most of us, it's drilled into us to shoot in manual mode. But I would have lost a lot of pictures today if I wasn't in aperture mode. I just kept it down to f4 because I wanted as much bokeh as I could get. And I let the camera do the thinking for me. And really, with today's cameras, I think you can really do that. So anyway, I really appreciate you watching, and keep looking and keep shooting.